Good morning, this is Blair and Jonathan from Dream Doctor. We're just at the Aero / Fletcher's site at the Wellington Airport. Just CCTVing and getting the condition report, also locating the ducts, 150mm. There are four of them. We're just at the first pit from the room, comms room, and we're just going back up towards that room. So hopefully we should be there shortly. I'm just going to zero the camera and just get a general condition. But this is duct one, so we're going to do one to four all the way back to the building, and then we're going to go one to four from this pit out towards the aero site.
Okay, so as you can see at this point here,
at approximately 16 metres roughly, it does start going underwater. So I probably will have to locate that, but I am just going to carry on and try and get to the end of the duct and see how far it is underwater, and then go from there. Okay, so I just went and cleaned the camera head to see the cobwebs are in the lens, so I've cleaned that, and I have also sprayed it and stuck one inside the building from the door, so now I'm just going to pull it back and go start filming. Okay, so now we're in duct two. You can see there's a bit of stuff in the bottom of it, so that may come up over the lens, but I'll do my best to try and keep it clear, as we can't really get a guide down there. There's not much room, so yeah, I'm just going to zero the camera and then carry on. Okay, so as you see, we've started going underwater. We're just going to quickly try to put the riser on and try and put that through there somehow. Someone has tried to use this as like a guide wire, so what I'll try to do, it works about 9 metres in, so it's nothing that we've done, but I'll try and pull this all the way out to this manhole where we've accessed, and hopefully we can get all the way through, then we can hold it tight so it doesn't even land the camera. we'll pull it all the way back, and we're about a metre out from the chamber clip, we're back to, so we're going to go to the other room and see if it is quite off, which it does seem. Hopefully we can add a little bit more to it, and then pull the camera out, unattach it, and then attach it again, so then push the camera back up. Okay, so this is duct 2. As you can see, I have tied that on up there and just had to extend that like I said before. So now we can pull it through and not going to affect that draw wire. So I'm just going to pull it back now and then we'll go to duct 3. Okay, so now we're on duct number 3 and heading back towards that same comms room. Okay, so here you can see it about 7 metres in. There's the little compaction damage on the bottom of the pipe. I'm not too sure if that will affect the size of the cables going through this duct, but depending on the size of the cable, it could do. And it hasn't actually gone all the way through, so I don't think it's leaking water through there. But it's hard to tell, but I'll probably carry on now. Mark all this stuff out afterwards. Okay, so as you can see here, there's half a pair of earmuffs. As you can see, so someone's walking around with just one on at the moment, probably. But I don't know if we're going to be able to try and pull that out or try and push it along. Give it a go, but I don't know what's going to end up happening there. We might have to dislocate that, and that may have to. Oh, no, I've hooked it there. So I might as well actually try and pull that all the way out, and I'll see what I can do. Okay, so we're just going to try and grab it from the other end, that the mining grid end up at inside the main switchboard room, comms room. So we're just going to see if we can pop that cap open and reach down and grab it out from this section here. Hopefully we can. I was just looking for something else to get. Awesome, so there you can see the scrap them out, that's good. A little bit of technical camera work going on, but we're just going to pull it back now, and that's going to be the recording of duck number 3. Okay, so now we're just at the start attack number 4, so I'll reset the camera again. We're just trying to get the camera in there without being so dirty and messing up the lens. Okay, so as you can see here, there's quite significant crushing on this one, similar to the other one, but this one is a lot worse. You can see just the level that cable's gone through it has risen quite high, so depending on what else could be going through here, if it's just an 80mm duct or cable or anything like that, I wouldn't like the chances of that getting through there, so I will probably mark that one on the way back. And a lot of these ducts do have water in them, again as you can see here, they go in and out of water quite a lot, so depending on what cable is going through there, may want to look into that as well. Okay, so that's the end of the recording. The duck before, as you've seen, someone must have been playing golf or mucking around. So we're just going to try and pull the camera back now. A lot of it is underwater as well. And there also is that big action dent in the pipe. So we'll just pull it back. And that's going to be the recording from the pit, first pit, to back to the comms room or the switchboard, the main switchboard room. So then we'll start off on duck number one heading down towards the arrow site from this pit. Okay, so here we are, we're just straight away in number one, from the pit heading down towards the aero site. Okay, so this is the duct number one from the pit down to the chamber pit kind of thing inside the aero site. The first chamber inside the aero site.
By the lifting.
By the lifting platform. So we will be going and continuing on from these two pipes that you can see from this chamber. We will continue on after we do from 1 to 4 in this chamber to this point here. We will go through that chamber that you can see at the moment and go down those two pipes here and carry on. Okay, so now we're at the start of duct number two, heading towards the aero site. So we're just going to go down, hopefully we end up in that same chamber. Okay, so that was number two. Now we're moving to number three. So number two dipped through to that chamber, which is good. And number two ducks there, which could be going to nothing. But we're not too sure. Could be going to the chamber also. That's duck number three, heading towards the arrow site. Okay, so that there, it looks like it's been kept off somehow. There's a bit of plastic over the top of it, or the end of it, so we will pull back now and carry on with duck number four, and then we'll go into the arrow yard, grab lunch and then go out to the arrow yard. Okay, so now we're into duck number 4, so into the barrel duck. This is the last duck to go. So let's hear the Ingle Duck Dog number 4.